Hello everyone, my name is Ruchi Arora. I am working as an assistant professor in Bhavan's Leelavati Munshi College of Education. Today, I am going to explain the topic Maxims of Language Teaching, which comes under course titled Teaching of English as part of BEd second semester. In this video, you will develop clear understanding about the term maxim. You will also understand the importance of learning various maxims of language teaching. This video will not only enable you to know various maxims of language teaching, but will also enable you to learn how to apply these maxims in your everyday classroom teaching. Now, let us understand the general meaning of the term maxim. Maxims are general truths. They are short sayings. They could be in the form of a short proverb like early to bed, early to rise. You know, this is a short proverb that works well. It is a good rule of behavior. Similarly, maxims are general truths. They are short sayings. And most importantly, they are universally accepted. Now, the bigger question arises here. Why is it important for you all to know the various maxims of language teaching? The answer lies in the fact that as language teachers, you must be acquainted with various maxims of language teaching because these maxims have been formulated by the psychologists, educationists, and pedagogues, and they are based on sound empirical research findings. Moreover, they are easily applicable. They are very easy to apply. You can apply them easily in your everyday classroom teaching. And they are highly reliable. They have universal significance. And most importantly, they maximize learning of the language, which is the ultimate goal of a language teacher, right? So not only that, it is very important for all of you to learn maxims because they make teaching learning process interesting, joyful, easy, understandable, effective, and purposeful. Now, let us understand the various maxims of language teaching one by one in detail. The very first maxim of language teaching is known to unknown. You know, as this maxim is itself telling, go from something which is known, from there go gradually to something which is not known. So this maxim talks about making use of learner's prior knowledge or background knowledge. It could be the background knowledge of language, it could be the background knowledge of content, it could be the background knowledge of the real world that the child is part of. You know, this maxim talks about making use of this background knowledge of the learner to develop new language and maximize language learning. So when developing language with English learners, you must work to start where students are. This includes finding out what students already know about a new topic and helping them to make connections between what they already know and what they are learning. So whenever you are teaching a new topic, try to make connections with learners' cultural knowledge, prior knowledge of L1. Here L1 is home language or mother tongue. Not only this, if required, pre-teach key vocabulary to expand the background knowledge of the learners before teaching a new topic. So this maxim of going from known to unknown is actually helping the teacher to develop readiness among the learners. And I hope you all understand that readiness is very much important for learning to happen. Not only that, we all know that prior knowledge or the background knowledge is the key to comprehension. So this maxim talks about making use of that prior knowledge, background knowledge, and helping the child to understand what the child does not know with the help of what child already knows. Now let us understand another maxim of language teaching, which is simple to complex. We all know that we understand simpler things easier and faster in comparison to things which are complex. So this maxim of language teaching tells that while teaching any topic, we should always move from simple to complex. We should start from simple things, simple meanings, simple concepts, simple ideas, and gradually making it complex. For example, if you are teaching sentence structure to students, you know, you should always start with basic conversational sentences and gradually moving to making it more complex structures like questions, like negatives, like complex sentences, like compound sentences. So this will make the learning process of the student very easier and understandable and fast. Now let us understand another maxim of language teaching, which is concrete to abstract. Concrete is something which is tangible, which the child can experience, which the child can see through his sense organs. And abstract is something which is intangible, which the child cannot see. And we all know that, you know, children learn very easier and faster through their observation, through their sense organs, through their experiences. So this maxim of language teaching talks about making your language teaching and organizing your language teaching in such a way that you move from concrete to abstract. You move from tangible ideas, tangible things, tangible concepts to something which is intangible, which is abstract in nature. For example, if you are teaching the topic of nouns to students, you know, so nouns, the basic names of persons, the places, the animals, the things, the fruits that the child already know, or that the child already knows in his surroundings. So these are something that the child can relate to in his everyday life. So you can, while teaching the concept of noun, you can always, you should always move from simpler, concrete types of nouns like proper nouns, common nouns, and gradually moving to the other abstract nouns, which is a bit difficult for the child to understand. So you should always move from concrete to abstract while teaching any topic. Now let us understand another maxim of language teaching, which is whole to part. This maxim talks about that while teaching any topic or any rule or anything in language, you should always move from whole. You should always move from a holistic understanding to the parts understanding. Let me explain with the help of an example. Suppose if you are teaching any poem, you know, you should always start with the general theme of the poem. What the poem is talking about, what the poet is trying to say, what is the general theme of the poem. And then gradually you can move to its parts, like its each stanza, its each sentences, like its each difficult words, like its poetic devices, its rhyming scheme, its hidden meaning, the inferential meaning, the critical meaning, likewise. So, learning, language learning becomes effective when the teacher moves from holistic understanding to the specific understanding. Let me explain this with another example. Suppose also want to teach the concept of adjectives to students. So, you know, you should always start with a general understanding of the term adjective. What are adjectives? What do they do? They are describing words. What do they describe? You know, with this holistic and general understanding of adjectives, you can always move gradually towards parts like the various degrees of adjectives, the superlative, positive, comparative, and gradually moving to each type of adjectives like interrogative adjectives, descriptive adjectives, demonstrative adjectives, and so on. So this maxim guides teaching learning process in such a way that we should always move from a whole to part, holistic understanding to the specific understanding of the text. Now let us understand another maxim, which is induction to deduction. Induction means going from examples to general rules. And deduction is exactly the opposite of induction, which is general rules first and then giving examples. So this maxim of language teaching states that language learning becomes effective and maximized when, you know, when the teacher goes from induction to deduction. That means when the teacher presents examples, lots and lots of examples to students, and then the students, with the help of those language samples, with the help of those language examples, the child himself or herself deduce the general rule. You know, how does a child acquire L1, his mother tongue, his first language? Have you ever thought about it? Nobody teaches the child the explicit rules of his or her first language. Not all parents are language experts. Not all parents are language teachers. But still, every child acquires mother tongue so gradually and marvelously. This is because the child is given exposure to lots and lots of meaningful language samples, and with those examples and language samples, the child implicitly learns the various rules of the language. So language learning becomes effective when the teacher goes from lots and lots of examples to general rules. And rather than giving rules first, general rules first, and then asking the child to cram the general rules and then giving few examples. So you should always give lots and lots of examples and help the child construct the general rules or the laws of the language or the grammar himself or herself. In that way, his or her learning becomes more meaningful, more fruitful and purposeful, and he or she will be able to retain it for a much larger period of time. And most importantly, the child will be able to use that learning in his or her oral and written communication. Now moving to another maxim, which is psychological to logical. This maxim talks about while planning for your students any lesson or any chapter or any grammar topic or any activity, you should always move from psychological to logical. That means, you know, how much appropriate you are teaching, how much good you are teaching, how much well prepared you are. Your teaching will never become effective until and unless you take into consideration the psychological aspects of the learner, because psychological aspects are very, very important for the learning process. So whenever you are planning, you should take care of those psychological aspects like your learner's mental level, your learner's interest, your learner's aptitude, your learner's learning styles. So you should take care of all these psychological aspects while preparing your plans and while delivering lecture in the class. So this psychological aspects will really help you, or it will really make your teaching learning process more effective and purposeful. Next maxim we have is actual to representative. Here actual stands for the realia, the real objects, the natural objects, the actual objects that exist in the surroundings. And it may actual here also means the authentic materials that are already available, like notices from the school boards, from the housing societies, like newspaper articles, posters from the newspapers, and so on and on. You know, this maxim talks about that teacher, whenever the teacher is making any language material or preparing TLM, you know, the teacher should first, if possible, if it is available, the teacher should always make use of authentic materials or realia, if they are available. Because there's no point of preparing a very big model or charts and representative pictures and everything in the form of TLM when the realia is available, because the actual authentic material are more effective, are more purposeful, are more meaningful for the child. So whenever you are preparing teaching learning material, try using authentic material or realia if they are available. And yes, if they are not available, you can always prepare for representative pictures, charts, flashcards, models, etc. For example, if you are teaching the concept of prepositions, okay, so instead of preparing big models, charts, flashcards, what you can do, make use of the child, the student, the learner as a resource. You can ask simpler questions. Where are you sitting? Who is sitting in front of you? What is above you? What is below? What is under you? Who is sitting next to you? Who is sitting beside you? And you know, you can ask them to play a game in which they are changing their different positions. So you are actually making use of the child as a resource here, and no other representative big models, charts, pictures are required. You know, this makes not only helps the child in effective understanding of the concept, but also helps the child in active engagement in the class. The child is more able to relate to those authentic materials and realia. So we should always move from actual to representative. The next maxim is definite to indefinite. Definite is something which is fixed, which we can predict, and indefinite is something which is not fixed. So this maxim talks about going from definite to indefinite. That means whenever we are teaching any topic, we should always teach those things which are fixed first, and then gradually moving to the exceptions and the indefinite things. For example, if you are teaching the rules of grammar, for example, I'm taking the example of plural, how plural is formed in English. So the definite rule of making plural in English, I mean, which is generally applicable, is adding S to the noun at the end, books, pens, pencils. But you know, so this is a definite rule. You should always start with such definite rules in order to make the comprehension easier and faster for the children, and then gradually moving to indefinite rules. For example, when the noun ends with S, then we don't add S to make it plural. We add ES, like buses, glasses, classes. So, you know, and there may be many other adding REN, for example, to child, to make it plural, children. So such indefinite rules can wait, you know, or can wait for a later stage. You should always move from definite to indefinite. Now, moving to another maxim of language teaching is empirical to rational. Empirical is something that we can experience, and rational is something that we understand through logic and reasoning. So this maxim of language teaching talks about making your language teaching and organizing your language teaching in such a way that you always move from empirical to rational. You always make use of the child's experiences, the child's surroundings first, and then gradually moving to ideas and concepts which require reasoning, logic, and higher order thinking skills, problem solving, and so on and on. For example, let me explain this maxim with the help of an example. For example, if you are teaching a prose, okay, If you are teaching a prose, then you should always start with a empirical direct meaning of the story, what the author is saying, what happens in the story, and asking the child to relate to its real life, what the child understood through his or her own experience, and then gradually moving to something, the inferential meaning, the critical meaning, the interpretive meaning of the prose. What does the child do if she or he would have been in that place, where she needs to apply logic and reasoning and creativity and critical thinking? Is the ending right or wrong according to the child? So the child needs to develop logic and reasoning for that. So it's always better to move from empirical to rational, trying to make connections with the child everyday experiences, and then going to something which is abstract, which requires logic, which requires reasoning, going from empirical to rational. I hope I have been able to make you understand the various maxims of language teaching, and I hope you have understood its meaning, not only its meaning, but also you are able to understand how to apply these maxims in your everyday classroom teaching, because that is more required and that is more meaningful. Understanding maxims theoretically will not serve any purpose. What is important for you to understand how to apply and integrate all these maxims in your everyday classroom teaching. If you want to read further about this topic, then you can read these books. There's a book by Krashen, Explorations in Language Acquisition and Use. And you can always look at How Languages Are Learned. It's a book by Oxford University Press. Then you can also look at National Focus Group Position Paper on Teaching of English. You can always look at this book of Thought and Language, New York.